Students, hope you all are fine. We were studying carbohydrate metabolism, under which we have already covered glycogenolysis and glycogenesis. Second part is breakdown of glucose to release energy, which is completed in three steps. Under this, the first part is glycolysis. Glycolysis is also known as Emden-Meyerhof-Parnas pathway, after the name of discoverers. So you may be asked, EMP pathway also, EMP pathway. So this pathway, it involves breakdown of 6 carbon glucose into 2 molecules of 3 carbon pyruvic acid. So glucose will break down to form 2 molecules of pyruvic acid or pyruvate. So it is an anaerobic pathway. It does not require presence of oxygen and it occurs in cytoplasm of all these cells. Now what are the 9 steps of glycolysis? First step is phosphorylation. Phosphorylation, as I have already told you, this is the addition of phosphate. So here just see, kinase enzyme will play an important role in attachment of phosphate group as well as in detachment of phosphate group. So just see, glucose in presence of ATP molecule and magnesium ions and enzyme hexokinase. Hexo because glucose is a hexo sugar. Kinase is the name of enzyme. So hexokinase. What happens, ATP separates to form ADP and inorganic phosphate. That phosphate attaches to glucose at carbon atom 6, resulting in the formation of glucose-6-phosphate. So first step is phosphorylation, addition of phosphate, which converts glucose into glucose-6-phosphate. Second step is rearrangement. Glucose-6-phosphate changes into its isomeric form, that is, its isomerase fructose-6-phosphate. So what will be the name of enzyme? As I have told you, it will be phosphoglucoisomerase. Arrangement is rearrangement, that is isomerization. So second step is isomerization or rearrangement, converting glucose-6-phosphate into fructose-6-phosphate. As it is isomerization, so name of enzyme is phosphoglucoisomerase. Then the next step is again phosphorylation. Again, ATP molecule gives its phosphate in presence of magnesium ions. So that phosphate now attaches to carbon atom 1 of fructose. So fructose-6-phosphate changes into fructose-1,6-diphosphate. So name of enzyme is phosphofructokinase. Phosphofructokinase. So this is the third step. Fourth step is splitting. In splitting, 6 carbon sugar breaks to form 2 molecules of 3 carbon sugars, triose sugars. So name of enzyme over here is aldolase, you have to remember it. So fructose-1,6-diphosphate, it forms 2 molecules of 3 carbon sugar. One is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, second is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Keep in mind, these two sugars, they are interconvertible. So what will be the name of enzyme? These are basically isomers. So name of enzyme will be, as both of them they are triose sugar, so it will be phosphotriose isomerase. Dihydroxyacetone phosphate can change into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate can change into dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So thus simply they are interconvertible. Now keep in mind, dihydroxyacetone phosphate, as it changes into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, it means now we have 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So here we are taking reactions of only 1 molecule. But when you calculate the net reaction, you have to take into account 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So next step is phosphorylation and dehydrogenation, means addition of phosphate, which is now taken from phosphoric acid. It is not taken from ATP. Second step is dehydrogenation. It is removal of hydrogen. That hydrogen is picked up by coenzyme NAD. NAD stands for nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. So which is reduced to NADH. Here I have explained you, I will explain it to you in the end, that how NAD reduces to NADH. So what will be the name of enzyme? The name of enzyme will be 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde dehydrogenase. So as I have told you, this part is taken from the name of substrate. This part is taken from the name of reaction, and in the end we are placing suffix -ase. So changing glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate into 1,3-diphosphoglycerate or 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. When it is present in the ionic form, we say it is glycerate. Next, sixth step is again dephosphorylation. Dephosphorylation means removal of phosphate. So that phosphate is picked up by ADP, which changes to ATP. So you have to place arrowhead. ADP changes to ATP. And the name of enzyme over here will be diphosphoglycerate kinase. As I have told you, kinase involves removal of phosphate as well as it catalyzes addition of phosphate. So diphosphoglycerate kinase, converting 1,3-diphosphoglycerate to 3-phosphoglycerate. It means phosphate group from first position detaches and attaches to ADP to form ATP. Next step is rearrangement. Phosphate group from third carbon shifts to second carbon. So third phosphoglycerate changes to 2-phosphoglycerate. Name of enzyme is phosphoglycerate mutase, because it involves only shifting of phosphate group from third carbon to second carbon. Eighth step is dehydration, means removal of water. So water is lost from 2-phosphoglycerate in presence of enolase enzyme to form phosphoenol pyruvate. And the last step is dephosphorylation. Dephosphorylation means removal of phosphate. So that phosphate is again picked up from phosphoenol pyruvate, which changes to pyruvate, and that phosphate is picked up by ADP, that changes to ATP. The name of enzyme over here is pyruvate kinase. So just see, as I have told you, now there are two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So two molecules will produce 2-pyruvate. So it means one molecule of glucose breaks to form 2 molecules of pyruvate. So these are 9 different steps of glycolysis. Now if you have to write net reaction, so we are taking up 1 molecule of glucose, then as these are 2 molecules, so it will be 2 NAD. So 2 NAD, they are reduced to 2 NADH. Then we have taken 2 ADP only. Just see, these are 2 ADP in 1 molecule. If there are 2 molecule, there will be 4 ADP, which will change into 4 ATP. But here 2 ATP they are consumed. So net gain is 4 ATP they are produced. As these are 2 molecules, 4 ATP they are produced, but 2 ATP they are consumed. So the net gain is 2 ADP they are changing to form 2 ATP. So we are taking 2-phosphate molecules from phosphoric acid. Two molecules of phosphoric acid they are participating. So the end result is we are getting 2-pyruvate, 2-NADH, 2-ATP and 2-hydrogen ions, 2 protons. Now just see, here I have explained you how this reduction process takes place. Each hydrogen atom splits to form 1 proton and 1 electron. So when NAD positive means after taking 1 electron, it will change to NAD. So now when 2 hydrogen atoms they are added, they will split into 2 protons and 2 electrons. So 2 electrons they combine with NAD plus 1 proton, 1 proton combines with NAD, reducing it to NADH, and naturally 1 proton is left behind. Is it clear? 2 hydrogen atoms they will split to form 2 protons and 2 electrons. 2 electrons they combine with NAD plus 1 proton combines with NAD to form NADH, and 1 proton is left behind. Now regarding regulation of glycolysis, this is the third step which regulates the process. Regulation means at which speed this glycolysis will take place in the cells. If this process is catalyzed by phosphofructokinase, if the level of ATP in a cell rises, phosphofructokinase is inhibited. It stops this reaction. So no further glycolysis takes place. If the level of ATP in a cell is low, then phosphofructokinase is activated and glycolysis is continued. So this is the level of ATP which affects this enzyme फॉस्फोफ्रक्टोकाइनेस विच रेगुलेट्स द रेट ऑफ ग्लाइकोलिसिस। सो जदों सैल विच एटीपी दा लैवल बढ़ता वा फॉस्फोफ्रक्टोकाइनेस आ जिहड़ा कम करना बंद कर दिंदा ते फर्दर ग्लाइकोलिसिस नहीं हुंदी। जदों सैल दे विच एटीपी दा लैवल घटदा एडीपी दा लैवल बढ़ जांदा तां फॉस्फोफ्रक्टोकाइनेस आ जिहड़ा एक्टिवेट हो जांदा ते ग्लाइकोलिसिस आ जिहड़ी उह शुरू हो जांदी है। सो दिस इज़ हाउ रेगुलेशन ऑफ ग्लाइकोलिसिस टेक्स प्लेस। सो दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट दिस ईएमपी पाथवे दैट इज़ ग्लाइकोलिसिस।